What is the best and safest way to install the lug nuts on your wheels? We've got the details. We'll share them when we get back. I'm Tim Johnson, and you're watching Shop Tool Reviews. I don't believe that I've ever done a review or video article where I've needed my laptop while I'm filming. But there's so much data in this, I don't want to forget it, and I don't want to misrepresent it, so I want to have it right here in front of me. So you may see me looking at my spreadsheet from time to time. But for a long time now, as battery-powered impacts grow, as they get more powerful, we're starting to see the move in, you know, whether it's tire shops, mechanics, what have you, of people going to battery-powered impacts. Now, also, we're seeing nicer and nicer wheels go on the cars, even from the original manufacturers. And so then the requirement of having torque wrenches is even greater to make sure that we're not over-tightening over-torquing lug nuts or even under-tightening them. So we want to make sure that we're hitting those torque specs. Now, what's the best way to do so? Because we've got pneumatic impacts in shops, which in tire shops I think is still the majority. Just because they're light, they're also a little cheaper. And we've got everything from big monster, you know, impact wrenches like the Mac Tools here, that's just a pure beast, a really good gun, very powerful. We got Sun-X Tools compact gun that's still capable of 500 or 600 foot-pounds. And then we've got Milwaukee's 2863, which is their high torque, half inch impact. This has their One Key app as well, where you can actually control it, set some torque features and so forth. It's capable of 1,400 foot-pounds of nut-busting torque or 1,000 or 1,100 foot-pounds of tightening torque. And so there's a lot of differences here, and then you have your old torque sticks and your torque wrench. Now, we wanted to kind of set the bar, set the example of what should be done in the shop, and are there different paths of getting the correct torque? And we all have those scenarios where we've gone to take the wheel off of one of our cars after the tires have been changed or rotated, and you gotta stand on the four-way lug wrench to get it off if you don't have an impact. Or your mid-torque won't take it off, so you gotta get your high torque. So my goodness, how tight were those lug nuts tightened? So we wanted to get an idea of what happens when you're tightening bolts with these different scenarios. Our control sample was using our Proto Digital Torque Wrench, which has been calibrated recently, so it's dead on. And we used an I-beam back here with nuts and bolts that are welded in place, or the actual bolts are welded into place, and then the nuts are on dual washers, so there shouldn't be any galling between anything. We get a true measurement of the torque. There shouldn't be any misrepresentation between the bolts, if you will. We were going to do this on lug nuts, but really we ran more than 100 nuts and bolts on and off, and I really didn't want to do that to a wheel or to lugs and gall them up or something like that. So we should be able to agree that if we set a control sample, regardless on kind of the whatever it's on, that we should be able to measure from there. So that's what we did. We used our I-beam with those nuts and with those bolts welded in place and the nuts on there to take our Proto torque wrench, and we torqued these bolts down, these nuts down to 100 foot-pounds. Now we did 5 at a time, and then we did 20 of them. So we did that 4 times over to get a control sample of 20. Then we came back and measured how much force with the torque wrench it took to remove those nuts that we just torqued on at 100 foot-pounds. So again, using the digital torque wrench for putting them on and taking them off, that should give us a good control sample to then measure the different impacts, torque sticks, what have you, against. So that's what we did. And it was pretty interesting. I would say that it was definitely in the range of where I thought it would be. Because by the way, when you hear of nut busting torque and it's always greater than the tightening torque, well, here's why. It's tougher to tighten a bolt. Again, you're continually increasing the tension on that bolt. You're continually stretching that bolt, so the tension's continuing to increase. So tightening a bolt is tougher than taking it off. So something you tighten to 100 foot-pounds probably only takes, you know, 15% less or 85% of that force to then back it off. And that is the case. After measuring 20 measurements, or after torquing those 20 different times and then measuring how much force it took to take off, we came with our control sample, and that was for those 20 bolts or 20 nuts tightened to 100 foot-pounds. it took an average of 85.4 foot-pounds to remove those. So that's our control sample with our torque wrench on and off. So that's what we go by. That's what we're going to continue to kind of measure against. So then we took our Milwaukee, the 2863 high torque impact. We put it in, we used the One Key app. We put it in the lug nut control mode in that first mode, which is 80 to 130 foot-pounds. Now that's a pretty wide spread. That's a 50 foot-pound spread. But again, that's what they have. They have two different lug nut modes, one for say passenger cars, light trucks, and the other one for trucks and, or actually for passenger cars and then for light trucks. And the light trucks is like 130 to 180, I believe is what the torque range is in there. But anyway, we tested it on the 80 to 130 foot-pounds. So that median should be, what, 105 foot-pounds, but let's just call it 100 since we have a 100-pound torque Husky torque stick as well. So we put in the low lug nut mode on the One Key app, and then we put the socket straight onto the impact wrench, and we ran the nuts on. Now, the nice thing about the app is I didn't have to watch the socket because the app actually shuts the tool down when it reaches that torque. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna use it like Milwaukee intended it. I'm gonna hold my finger on the trigger and not let off of it. And you'll see, when I was running the test, I held my finger on it and until the tool actually stopped. And you hear it hammering away and then it just shuts down. I pulled it off, then released the trigger, went to the next one, pulled the trigger, held it on there till it stopped and so forth. So we'll share those results in just a moment. Then again, and removing the torque or removing the nuts that were tightened on by the Milwaukee, we used the digital torque wrench to then measure the force it took to take those off. Next up, we took the Mack Tools beast of an impact wrench. Again, really nice impact wrench. And we used that with Husky's 100 foot-pound torque stick. And so we also put it in the middle mode. So in other words, there's three power modes, 1, 2, and 3. We put it in the middle. So we say, hey, maybe, you know, roughly 500-600 foot-pounds. We think that's a good median range. We'll put it in that level with the torque stick. And then as soon as that socket stops, you can see it actually moving as you're tightening. As soon as it stops, release the trigger, go to the next one. So we did that. And again, we measured it 20 times over. And then we measured how much force it took to take off with the Proto torque wrench. Again, put those in our spreadsheet, share those in a moment as well. Again, move on to the Sunex Tools impact wrench, their compact impact with the Husky torque stick, the 100 foot-pound torque stick and the socket. And again, same thing, as soon as we see the socket stop, we remove it, then we measure the force it takes to take it off with the Proto torque wrench, and we compile that data as well. So before I share the results, we did some more tests. Because I know some of you are gonna say, well, why didn't you test this way? And why didn't you test this way? And why didn't you do this? And why didn't you do this different? We did those, but let me share those with you after I share the results, because I really don't think it makes a difference. And again, you can make a determination of that after I share it with you. So here's the results from those three tests we talked about. Now, the control sample, again, as I shared with you, was 85.4 foot-pounds. So there's our control sample. Everything else is going to be measured based off of that control sample. We're all going to agree that our torque wrench was at least on good enough to where it, you know, was able to measure the same amount every time, 20 times over and 60, 80, 100 times over. So first up, the Milwaukee 2863 high torque impact with the One Key app, set at the lug nut, the first lug nut mode. There's two lug nut modes, the lower one, the number one mode. It differed from the control sample less than 0.1%. So the average on the control sample was 85.4 foot-pounds. The average on the Milwaukee was 85.9 foot-pounds. So looking at that on a 100-point scale, on a percentage range, that equaled, I'm sorry, 0.4% from the control sample. So a differing of 0.4% between the Milwaukee with the One Key and the actual controlled sample with the torque wrench. Now, looking at the Mack Tools gun with the Husky torque stick on it. So the average amount of foot-pounds, the average amount of force it took to remove the lug nuts from the nuts that were put on with the Mack Tools gun was 137.6 foot-pounds. So again, the control sample was the 85.4, and with the Mack Tools gun, it was 137.6. So that's 52.2% higher than the control sample. One of the glaring things here too is one of the nuts torqued at over 214 foot-pounds with the Mack. So getting into dangerous territory there of really hurting a wheel, hurting a customer's car, if you will, when you're getting that high. You're more than doubling your torque needs using that gun with that torque stick in that way. So again, that was one time out of 20, but still. And here's another area where we actually then took the sample and said, well, what if we took the highest and lowest number and threw them out, called it an anomaly, and then measured it, and I'm telling you, still between the control sample to all of them, there still was within 3%. So we agreed to use all the numbers, so all 20 numbers, not throw out the high and the low, but I just wanted to let you know that we did that and looked at that, but still the samples, they all still remained within 3%. So we decided to use the original control sample with all 20 numbers in it for all the guns. So we've got the control sample at 85.4 foot-pounds, we've got the Milwaukee at 85.9 foot-pounds, and we've got the Mack Tools with the torque sticks at 137.6 foot-pounds. Now we moved on to the Sun-X Tools gun, their compact gun with the same Husky 100 foot-pound torque stick, and what we had there was it differed 46.7% from the control sample, and that was an average of 132.1 foot-pounds. So you can see with the pneumatics, with the torque stick, it still, even though we tried to stop it right as soon as that socket stopped, we were still way over it, 40 and 50% over the control sample as far as removing those nuts. So that's getting, again, kind of in the dangerous territory there. You're not wanting to over-tighten those that much. You're gonna warp a wheel, you're gonna hurt something, you're gonna gall some threads, and the customers just aren't gonna like it. Okay, so we know the results of the test. Let's talk about a couple of other tests that we performed just to kind of make you happy, if you will. So we also took the Mack Tools air impact with the torque sticks, and we backed the nuts off three turns. So this is really typical what you see in most tire shops. You see the lug nuts get started by hand, maybe a turn or two, and then they take the impact wrench and they run it on and let it hit for 3 or 4 seconds, 5 seconds, and then move on to the next one. So we did that because before we were using it with the nut already snug up against the washer and then using the impact. Now we backed it off three full turns and then used the impact to run it off. And with the Mack Tools gun, with them backed off three turns, it differed 83.7% from the control sample. In other words, the average went up to 169.1 foot-pounds. So that's definitely a no-no. If you're seeing guys that are actually running those on with the nuts backed off, that's a bad thing. The Milwaukee One Key Impact even went up 29.3% with the nut backed off three turns. So the average went from the 85.9 foot-pounds to 114.8 foot-pounds. So a significant jump just by having those nuts backed off of the lug. And then we said, well, what if we took the Milwaukee Impact and we used the One Key app, so we used the lug nut app, and we put the torque stick on, what would happen? That was the other side of the scale. It actually set it so low, it was like 18% below, or 16.8% below the control sample. So the actual average amount of force to take those off was 68.6 foot-pounds. So the One Key app with the high torque impact in conjunction with the 100 foot-pound torque stick, Husky Tools torque stick, was not a good idea either, unless you're coming back with a torque wrench, which that's great. But again, kind of know why even use the torque stick. But again, that drastically set low. So then what about the other side of that coin? Let's use the torque stick on the Milwaukee Impact and turn off the One Key app. Just put it on full bore, number four setting, wide open. You know, hold it on there till it, you know, stops turning. And the sudden you see that socket stop turning, then stop. That was crazy. It actually maxed out our torque wrench. It was a 250 foot-pound torque wrench, and I was trying to break all of them loose, and they all maxed it out. So I stopped with the torque wrench. I didn't want to hurt our torque wrench, but it was just screaming at me at the max 250 foot-pounds. So I had to use an impact to actually take those off. So we'll call that 250 plus foot-pounds all day long when using the torque stick with a high torque impact. So got nowhere near 100 foot-pounds like they talk about. And again, I didn't hold it on there for a long time, but I put it on four, I put it on the high setting, I ran it on as soon as you saw the socket start to stop, and I pulled that off, and that's what we got. So do not use a torque stick with a battery-powered impact. Some people will take and index their socket, as you can see here, and then they'll measure the amount of force it takes to tighten just a little bit past the turn of what at what point the impact actually stopped, because that's going to give you the truer reading of torque. I didn't like that. Again, across the board on all three tools, the numbers differed so much because I think there's so many motor skills going on that you're trying to look at seeing when that socket starts to turn and seeing the reading on the tool. And again, differing from loosening, when you're tightening, now all of a sudden this torque wrench is measuring the max, the peak torque. So if you go past the point of just a little bit, now you're measuring a greater force than what it really took. So again, I will say that was erratic across the board on all three. So I think that's a bad sample. I think going with the the loosening torque it takes to break those loose is the best scenario, and agreeing what that difference is a good control sample. So we threw that out as well. And then we also validated the 100 foot-pounds, and then, setting the 100 foot-pounds with the torque wrench and then breaking it loose at 85.4. And we said, well, let's torque them all at 200 foot-pounds and then measure the forces, see if that window's still the same as far as what it takes to break those loose. So we torqued them all to 200 foot-pounds, and the average to break them loose was 164.2 foot-pounds. So that differed by 3% from the original control sample. So again, it was close enough that we called our original control sample good. So sharing all that data, hope you trust our information. I'll share it all with you, that's no problem, as you've seen it here on the video. I will tell you, at this moment in time, I don't know of another torque wrench that is actually measuring the torque from their impact, so that's why we have the Milwaukee here. There may be some others, we've heard wind of others that may be coming out with one, but that's the only one I know of. So, would I trust this after using it? Yeah, I think I would. I don't have a problem now using that gun to kind of set the preliminary tightening on my lug nuts, but I'm still coming back with a torque wrench and putting a torque wrench on it for that final reading. I don't think I could ever trust torque sticks. I think that if I see a tire shop using torque sticks, I'm gonna say, hey, snug those up, and I want to see a torque wrench come out and actually tighten my lug nuts, because I don't believe in those torque sticks. I've seen them now, actually, and now measuring it, and I just don't know that. I think it was a good idea as a stopgap for maybe ruining lug nuts and stuff, but I don't think it's a good stopgap. I don't think it's a good tool for the job. I think the right way to do it is to put your torque wrench on some low setting, snug those lug nuts up, come back with a torque wrench and torque those bolts down where they need to be. There you have it. That's our data on what we think the safest and best way is to install the lug nuts, and that's with the finality being a torque wrench. If you didn't catch it in the video, reach out to us. We'll be happy to share the data with you. Also, please subscribe to this channel and hit that bell button if you want to be notified of future videos. And be sure to keep track of us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Have a great day.